Here on the BL stand, the big news, of course, is the Triumph Acclaim, announced 2 weeks ago and already seen in great detail by regular Wheels viewers. But of course, there's a wide range of motorcars on the BL stand and a wide range of prices. There's the Mini City for under £3,000, the highly successful Metro range, of course, up through the Morris Ital cars, that's the facelifted Morris Marina to you and me, the Princess range, and of course the other new car on the stand, the four-door Range Rover. And that price range comes out at a shade under £20,000 for this fabulous Daimler 66. They're also showing the XJS HE, a new version of the stylish sports car that they claim won't cripple your wallet. Don't worry about the plastic bonnet, it's only there to frighten the DIY enthusiasts. Now, with this new engine, they've succeeded in bringing the fuel consumption of the XJS down from a crippling 12.7 to the gallon to an amazing 15.3, and that makes all the difference when you're shelling out £20,000 for a motorcar.
There's good news and bad news on the Volkswagen stand. The good news is that they are showing the new range of Passat saloons and Passat estates. The bad news is, as you can see, that they are not showing the new Volkswagen Polo, which was introduced in Germany just a few weeks ago. Now, Volkswagen's excuse for this is that the car will not be available in the United Kingdom until the new year, but we think they've missed an opportunity. Anyway, as for the Passats, well, they're sleek and smooth, all right, and they put me in mind rather of the Audi 80, although Volkswagen say they simply don't compete. But they are now the most expensive cars in the Volkswagen range. A GL5 estate Passat, for instance, will now cost you over £7,500. However, when we drove the cars a few weeks ago, we formed a very good impression of the smaller of the two units. That's the 1600cc four-cylinder engine, rather than the slightly more glamorous 1900cc five-cylinder. And of course, all the Volkswagen cars come, if you want it, with the optional fuel economy package, Formula, or as they spell it, Formel E, which we showed you last week.
BMW have been doing very nicely, thank you, during the current recession, which must say something about all those moans and groans that there isn't any money around at the moment. Their latest car is the 5 Series, which really looks quite like the old model, except that it incorporates new suspension, new electronics, and a lot more interior space. A world first for BMW is the service interval indicator, which tells you when the car needs a service. An onboard computer works that out according to the way in which you've been driving the car. BMW have been doing a lot of research lately to try and improve the economy on the drive of their cars without losing any of the performance for which, of course, they're renowned. It's a difficult combination to achieve, but it seems that they might well have cracked it with the 5 Series.